in our third month of lockdown in Melbourne this week, many of us have fallen into something of a routine. Homeschooling and working from home are now the norm, with many claiming to be running like a well-oiled machine. But as deaths continue to rise worldwide, many in aged care, and we continue to be confined to our homes for most of the day, a feeling of low-lying anxiety pervades our daily lives, and a sense of grief for all we have lost is constantly at play. This heightens our response when we lose a loved one at this time, with extended family unable to attend the funerals of those lost. Experts say that we need to be mindful more than ever of last wishes, and that running roughshod over others' feelings will come at a cost.
Oh, pardon me, that bleeding piece of earth. That I am meek and gentle with these butchers. Oh, at the ruins of the noblest man that ever lived in the tide of times. Woe to the hand that shed this costly blood. Over thy wounds now do I prophesy, which like dumb mouths do ope their ruby lips to beg the voice and utterance of my tongue. A curse shall light upon the limbs of men. Furore intone lotte rifazione l'un l'altra versa straziera d'Italia. Ogni contrada. Il sangue e la rovina saranno si consueti. E divranno così familiare scene d'orrore agli occhi della gente che le madri dovranno sorridere nel mirare i loro bimbi appena nati squartati dagli attili della guerra. All pity choked with custom of fell deeds. Caesar's spirit, ranging for revenge. With Arte by his side, come hot from hell, shall in these confines, with a monarch's voice, cry havoc. And let slip the dogs of war. That this foul deed shall smell above the earth, with carrion men groaning for burial.